Welcome to the first lecture. We're going to take a look today at our place in the universe and try to wrap our minds around the sizes of things. The size of our planet, our solar system, our galaxy, and even the observable universe. And speaking of the universe, this is an image that was taken with the Hubble Space Telescope. It's actually a really small area of sky. If you can imagine taking a picture through a very small straw, that's the size of the sky we're talking about here. And even in this tiny area of sky, there are thousands of galaxies. Each smudge on this image is an individual galaxy with billions of individual stars. So let's get started. Where do we live in the universe? What is our cosmic address? Well, you know we live on planet Earth, or at least most of us claim to, and Earth is a planet in our solar system. The solar system consists of the Sun, the planets and their satellites, and many other smaller objects, such as asteroids and comets. And here is our Sun. This lovely image of the Sun was taken with a very special filter that allows in only a narrow band of light. It lets us see features like that big prominence in the upper right and solar flares. Our Sun is one of more than about 200 billion stars in the Milky Way galaxy. What's a galaxy? Well, a galaxy is essentially an enormous island of stars in space. There are many galaxies. Our home galaxy is named the Milky Way galaxy. Every star you see in the night sky is part of the Milky Way. This figure shows what the Milky Way would look like if we could somehow get outside of the galaxy and take a photo. Whenever you see an image labeled as the Milky Way, it's either an artist's interpretation or a photo of another spiral galaxy that looks like the Milky Way. We've never actually been able to get out of our galaxy and take an overhead photo of it. This drawing of the Milky Way shows its basic structure. It's shaped like a disk, there's a bulge in the center, and the majority of the stars live in the disk in the spiral arms. There's another component that is not shown here. There's also a large spherical halo with clusters of older stars. Our Sun is located about two-thirds of the way out in the disk in one of the spiral arms. Billions of other galaxies are scattered throughout space. Some are fairly isolated, but many are found in groups. Our Milky Way, for example, is one of the two largest galaxies among about 40 galaxies in the local group. Groups of galaxies with more than a few dozen members are known as galaxy clusters. The local group is one small part of the local supercluster of galaxies, which is one small part of the universe. This is an image of our neighboring galaxy, the Andromeda Galaxy, also part of the local group. On a very large scale, the universe has structure. Galaxies and galaxy clusters appear to be arranged in sheets and chains with large voids of emptiness between them. The superclusters are where the galaxies are clumped together. Everywhere we look in the universe, we see this overall structure. There are a variety of units that are used for measuring distance, but there are two that are often used in astronomy. The first is the astronomical unit, or AU. The astronomical unit is Earth's average distance from the Sun, and it's about 50 million kilometers or 93 million miles. The AU is useful for smaller measurements. For larger scales, we generally use the light year. A light year is the distance that light can travel in 1 year. Light is pretty darn fast, so it can cover a lot of space in a year. A light year amounts to 10 trillion kilometers or about 6 trillion miles. It's important to remember that a light year is a measure of distance, not time. Also, nothing travels faster than light. It's the universal speed limit and it's a constant. The speed of light is 300,000 kilometers per second. Because it's a special number, it gets its own special letter. The speed of light is denoted by the letter C. The C stands for celeritas, which is Latin for rapid or swift. Light has a finite speed. So it means that it takes a certain amount of time for light to travel from an object to us, even for close objects. You never see anything in real time. Consider the moon. It takes light from the moon 1 second to reach us on Earth. It takes light from the sun about 8 minutes to reach us. This means if something really wonky happened right at this moment on the sun, we would not know about it for another 8 minutes. Sirius is a nearby star. It takes light 8.6 years to reach us from Sirius. Light from the Andromeda galaxy spends 2.5 million years traveling to reach Earth. This means we see objects as they were in the past. And the farther away we look in distance, the further back we look in time. Here is another example. You've probably seen the beautiful constellation Orion in the winter sky. He's very distinct with his three belt stars. Below Orion's belt is a sword, and within his sword is a nebula. You can see it as a fuzzy object with your naked eye in the sky. The image here is what it looks like to the Hubble Space Telescope. This nebula is actually a region of star formation. Behind those clouds of gas and dust, new stars are being born. The Orion Nebula is located about 1,400 light years away from us. How long does it take light to travel from the Orion Nebula to Earth? It takes 1,400 years. Here is the lovely Andromeda Galaxy again. The Andromeda Galaxy is actually bright enough that you can see it with your naked eye from a dark sky site. It looks a little bit like a fuzzy cotton ball. From Rockville or anywhere with city lights, we need binoculars or a telescope to see it. If you could go out tonight and see the Andromeda Galaxy, the light that would hit your eye left that galaxy 2.5 million years ago. When will we be able to see what the Andromeda Galaxy looks like right now at this very moment? We have to wait 2.5 million years. We estimate that the universe is about 14 billion years old, and we'll talk all about how we know this later in the semester. Because of the finite speed of light, the farther away something is, the longer it took the light to reach us. For example, the light from a galaxy 7 billion light years away took 7 billion years to reach us. So we see the galaxy as it was 7 billion years ago. The light from a galaxy 12 billion light years away from us took 12 billion years to reach us. So we see that galaxy as it was 12 billion years ago. If we try to look beyond 14 billion light years, we'd be looking to a time more than 14 billion years ago. And this is before the universe existed, so there's nothing for us to see. The distance of 14 billion light years therefore marks the boundary or the horizon of the observable universe. And the observable universe is the portion of the entire universe that we could potentially observe. It's difficult to wrap our mind around sizes and distances of things in astronomy, even for things as near as our solar system. So it's sometimes helpful to think about astronomical distances by scaling them down, just like we scale the size of cities down using a map. This figure shows our solar system shrunk down to a scale so that the sun is about the size of a large grapefruit. Please note that the distances are definitely not to scale. Using this scale, Jupiter is about the size of a tiny marble, and Earth is even smaller. Wouldn't it be nice if we could walk through a scale model of our solar system? Well, we can. Downtown on the National Mall, outside of the National Air and Space Museum, there is a scale model of the solar system that you can walk through. Earth on this scale is located about 15 meters from the sun, and Pluto is just a short walk away at about 600 meters or a third of a mile. We can also put on the scale how far humans have ventured. Even though we have sent out probes, the Voyager probes, to the edge of the solar system, real people have only been as far as the moon. And on this scale, the moon is about 4 centimeters away. Ever wonder how many stars there are in our universe? Well, there are hundreds of billions of galaxies, and in each galaxy there are hundreds of billions of stars. If you tried to count the number of stars in just the Milky Way, it would take you several thousand years. The universe is a very big place. We'll stop here for now. In the next lecture, we'll talk about the history of the universe and how we came to be.